how do we, in our right mind, justify what we have done to the world and what we've done to our sons and daughters? How can anybody justify what we've done? I don't know where to begin. This has been a nightmare for over 20 years that I've been involved, and it continues to be a nightmare. When we look at what has happened, the United States, going back many, many years ago, with all the downwinders and the atomic bomb testing and everything else, and then we had all the Agent Orange from Vietnam, then we kept going and we kept going with all the immunization mess, the Project Chad stuff, which is, again, deliberate use of chemical and biological warfare munitions on civilians all over the United States and the military, and that continues as we speak. And then we get to DU. Let's talk about depleted uranium specifics. First off, the term depleted is a misnomer. There's nothing really depleted about it. Uranium munitions are actually the byproduct of the uranium enrichment process conducted by the U.S. Department of Energy. For every 100 pounds of pure uranium that goes in the enrichment process, 99.2 pounds is pure waste. Okay? And that's what we call uranium hexafluoride, which is then processed to form uranium munitions. Uranium munitions consist of kinetic energy penetrators or bullets. So we have the 5.56 millimeter, the 7.62 millimeter, and the 50 caliber. Those are rifle bullets. They're made out of the uranium. Then we have the 20 millimeter for the Navy phalanx, the 25 millimeter for the Army Bradley fighting vehicle and the Marine Corps lab, etc. The 30 millimeter for on the gunships and everything in the A-10. Then we get up to the tank rounds, 105 millimeter, 125 millimeter, and the primary 120 millimeter. Now these are all gigantic slugs of uranium. And what they're actually made of is uranium hexafluoride, was the primary product that went into it. But what we end up with is these isotopes, uranium-234, uranium-235, which is uranium-236, uranium-238, which is the predominant amount, probably 99% of it, plutonium, neptunium, and americium. So we have a toxic radiological compound that this stuff is made up of. So what we end up with is a whole host of uranium munitions. The kinetic energy penetrators, which are like bullets or giant rods of uranium. Think a gigantic dart. You know, everybody's played darts. That's what these look like. Except that the tank round is 10 pounds of uranium. And the 30-millimeter round that's fired by the A-10 is 3/4 of a pound of uranium, fired at 4,000 rounds a minute. That's 1.5 tons of uranium on target per minute. Incredible amount of volume of uranium radioactive materials. And then up and beyond that, we have the Adem and the Pedem. Now, the Adem and the Pedem, think about a giant softball. The outer casing of the softball is made of uranium, DU, and it's filled with high explosives. Incredibly effective against all personnel and animals and children and everything else. Totally used by the Israelis in Lebanon. Totally used by the Israelis in Gaza, by the U.S. in the Balkans, and again, Iraq and Afghanistan. See, one of the things that the people would like everybody to believe is this stuff doesn't do anything until it hits the target, and that's pure nonsense. It's shedding immediately, and that's what we've proven to watch the videos and photographs. You can go back and pull up the stuff that we did for CBS Evening News with Dan Rather. You can pull up the stuff on 60 Minutes, on Dateline, Nightline, the BBC, the Canadian Broadcasting. You can see it all there. You can pull up the videos and actually look at it yourself and find out how it works. You know, so what we do know, the very earliest work that I know of and the work that I used for when I was director of the Depleted Uranium Project for the U.S. Army, I used all the research reports when the United States gave Israel uranium munitions to use against the Egyptians during the Arab-Israeli War in 1973. And so our 1974 report, which confirmed all the health and environmental effects, was written as a consequence of giving Israel the use of uranium munitions and using that Arab-Israeli War in 1973. Medical reports I've gotten for the UN troops and the other people that were on-site, totally confirmed. The medical problems are all there, the environmental problems, the on-site contamination that exists to this day out there in the Sinai is all confirmed. So that's where we had the earliest stuff. And then, again, we had an inventory, but we didn't really start to use it until Operation Desert Storm in 1990 and 1991. When these things are used, they create over extremely fine uranium dust, which is radiologically and chemically toxic. And now that creates air, water, soil, and food contamination. The Army's own documents state very clearly after this is used, it causes food and water contamination, makes food and water unusable for eternity. So we have all of that. So now what we're having is cross-contamination by ingestion, that's through eating and drinking. We have inhalation through breathing. We have absorption through the skin, and it goes right through the skin, just moves right in. And then obviously we have wound contamination through open wounds, or the dust getting in there and the shrapnel. So we have all of this stuff. So we have all the direct medical effects. Now, the U.S. Army orders, direct orders, require immediate radiobioassays.